thanks for joining us today at MeasureFest. We've got a great talk coming up now that's really going to dive into the details of web analytics and CRO. I hope you enjoy it.
Hello, and welcome to my talk. Today I'm going to be talking about interactive data studio reporting for Core Web Vitals performance, as well as progress tracking using Screaming Frog and Google Sheets. But first, who am I? Well, I'm just someone that loves to use data studio dashboards to make my life easier. And why this talk, you might ask? Well, in case you haven't noticed, Core Web Vitals is really hot right now. So just a quick word about what we're going to cover today. First, a little bit of context to the Core Web Vitals and the different methods and tools that can be used for auditing. Then we're going to talk about the challenge, or otherwise, the different pain points in the Core Web Vitals auditing process. Then we will consider an approach introducing the Core Web Vitals auditor dashboard, as well as going through different use cases for site, section, and page level reporting. Finally, we will also discuss some opportunities, or otherwise, different ways that you can supercharge this dashboard. So let's get started. We have consistently and continuously been getting news about this page experience ranking factor update that just finished a few days ago. For instance, here's what John Mueller has been saying over the past several months. First, start making changes and improvements early, as some fixes might not be as straightforward to others. Then, the page experience ranking factor would only apply to mobile data. Core Web Vitals are a part of the page experience factors, but are not the only Web Vitals that Google uses to determine rankings, even though this is what SEO Chatter has been focusing on recently. Speed, crawling, and rendering are still also very important. Google is keeping an eye on those other Web Vitals, and frankly, so should you. While a perfect score would be nice, a pass will also be sufficient. Well, needless to say, he's been saying a few other things too. But have we been listening? Perhaps not as much as needed. According to a Screaming Frog study, with a sample of over 20,000 URLs, only 12% of mobile pages pass the Core Web Vitals assessment. In the e-commerce space, 87% of websites fail Google's Core Web Vitals test. So apparently, and quite frankly, we probably need to step it up. So let's quickly recap what the three metrics measure. First, largest contentful paint measures loading performance. It should occur within 2.5 seconds of when a page first starts loading. First input delay measures interactivity. It should be less than 100 milliseconds. Cumulative layout shift measures visual stability. You should maintain a CLS of less than 0.1. What about those other Web Vitals that we mentioned previously? Well, those include mobile friendliness, safe browsing, HTTPS, no intrusive interstitials. But from the additional Web Vitals, one not commonly discussed, but in my opinion, quite important, is the time to first byte, which measures response speed. This should be around 200 to 500 milliseconds. There are two types of data that Google collects and analyzes, field data and lab data. And also, there is a wide array of tools that can be used, each of which has their own unique set of benefits, limitations, and use cases. So with all those tools at our fingertips, what could possibly be the challenge of auditing Core Web Vitals? Well, let me tell you, most tools are not user-friendly for site-wide auditing. Integrating all tools for a site-wide assessment of a medium or large site is near impossible. Page-level performance data can differ greatly across the different site sections. So what this means is getting a complete picture for patterns can be very difficult. Snapshot instruments such as the ChromeUX report don't enable section or page-level drill down. Exporting the full insights of the issues as patterns in the Google Search Console is sometimes obstructed by sampling limitations. What this results in is a number of different issues, all of which stall the potential improvements that can be done on a site. First of all, there is lack of ability for you, the auditor, to communicate and prioritize clearly. If you cannot identify all the pages for an observed issue, prioritization will struggle. Failing to communicate urgency to your developers will eventually stall implementations, because, as we all know, if there is no urgency, a task immediately gets put in the backlog and probably stays there forever. Second of all, you have an inability to spot the root cause of the issue. Oftentimes, a certain template or widget might be causing the issues that you're observing. Knowing where the issue is observed is the first step in its resolution. Finding all instances as an auditor or using the conventional tools is near impossible unless you are intricately familiar with the site's characteristics from a web development standpoint. Well, what you will struggle with the most, in my opinion, will be your ability to delegate things appropriately, especially for medium and large sites. Why? Well, they often have organizational silos, which manage different parts of the website. Let's take a quick detour. Imagine a site. It has its investor subdomain managed by one team, which typically handles legal as well. The PR subdomain or section managed by a PR firm. Content pages such as blogs and resource are typically managed by the content team in-house. Product and solution pages might be managed by product marketers internally as well. External parties will have developers for the section their affiliate firm manages, but you will also for sure have internal developers working on the sections handled by internal teams. So imagine having all of this, as well as a product and demand gen manager or head overseeing all of these teams, to whom you would need to report and to persuade them about the urgency of the fixes. Good luck with delegation if you can't filter by section. So what this will result in is a very slow auditing process. Even though web dev advises us to use all tools, implementing this in practice is near impossible. Then what will happen is your recommendations will also likely be non-actionable, because you will struggle to export and easily create actionable sheets for devs, or you'll spend a lot of time doing it. The lack of interactivity in many of the tools means exporting dev sheets with the specific URLs that the issues contain can be a big pain. Again, progress and impact tracking of fixes is done ad hoc. Site-wide auditing and audit comparison is unavailable for most tools. Most tracking is done either holistically by looking at site-level metrics, such as in the ChromeUX report, or page-by-page, such as the testing tools. So what can we do about it? Let's make Core Web Vitals interactive using Data Studio. Just plug and play in three simple steps. Bulk audit the Core Web Vitals with Screaming Frog. Copy the Data Studio dashboard and connect your data. Well, it might be more like seven steps, but bear with me. First, you would need to filter the bot traffic from the PageSpeed Insights API in Google Analytics. Then you would have to audit Core Web Vitals with Screaming Frog and export your crawl to a Drive spreadsheet. Then you will have to access and copy the dashboard template and connect your data to it. Here you will have two data sources, one for the ChromeUX report and the second one for your crawl. Some additional tips before you get started. First, get a feel for the site's categories. As I previously mentioned, it's best to talk to developers if there are any themes used across the site's main sections. Also, it might be good to check the CMS. This will enable you to provide recommendations which are focused and actionable. Finally, get access to Google Analytics. While optional, this can really help you supercharge the report and prioritize the implementation of recommendation. A quick word of caution here. You might also need to troubleshoot if there are any errors in the filters, as well as you would need to create your own custom dimensions or filters based on your site's sections. But voila, you should now have a fully functioning Core Web Vitals dashboard. So let's go through what the dashboard contains. First of all, in the performance section, you can get an overview of the site's performance and get a holistic picture of how your site is doing. Core Web Vitals metrics are shown side by side, reporting both field and lab data using the two data sources that we connected. Then you can view the savings opportunities at a glance. All savings opportunities will be available to you, as well as a clickable element with a link to web dev resources, just in case you are unfamiliar about how to resolve a particular issue. Then you can also filter pages by metric performance category. You can see all the pages that pass, fail, or need improvement in any of the three metrics. No values are excluded in here. You can also sort and filter pages by savings opportunities and values. You can see all of the individual opportunities on a page level for an individual URL. You can also sort and filter per metric value. You can finally filter the pages based on the keyword in the URL. This can be specifically useful if you have URLs that you have recently improved and you want to check upon, or you want to filter by sections such as the blog without creating a custom-made filter. That's all cool, but what else can it do? Well, to be honest, the possibilities are pretty much endless. Here are just a few other ways that you can supercharge this dashboard and make it your own. First of all, you can merge it with Google Analytics data for prioritization based on page visits, new users, or conversion metrics. You can also do this in Screaming Frog by pairing the crawler with your Google Analytics account, as well as do this in Data Studio via the native Google Analytics connector. What else? Well, you can create groups of pages based on the website section templates. Do this by creating a custom field with a regex filter. Incorporate a performance tracking sheet for changes and map out the impact of these changes. You can give your developers a list of recommendations based on the page experience issues that you're observing. Most probably, you are already doing that anyways. But by incorporating this, you will be able to see the different changes that they've implemented and how they have impacted the performance. You can also incorporate ChromeUX data for competitors and monitor how they are evolving over time. Shout out here to Rachel Anderson, who introduced this idea and developed the process for it. If you are like Cameron and you would like to know all the details about how to do this, then a full tutorial about how to do all of the setting up, as well as how to do everything mentioned so far, will be available for you over at my blog. But before I wrap up, I want to give you a few additional tips. First, don't be scared of seeing no values in the ChromeUX report. This only means that there isn't enough data collected for your site yet, or your site is new in the Search Console. This doesn't mean that you shouldn't implement any improvements. You can still implement them and get ready for being tested once you reach Google's visitor threshold. Overcome the site data freshness issues via Screaming Frog. Field data in the ChromeUX report is only reported once per month, but you can run crawls for lab data and tests as frequently as you'd like. Set up your crawl to reoccur bi-weekly or monthly. By doing this, you'll have more data to work with and visualize if any implementations have been made to the site. This will also allow you to showcase the different results to your client and in the same time, in the same dashboard, as well as show them the percentage change from when the last implementations have been done. Be wary of Google Data Studio limitations. I cannot stress this one enough. While you may want to view 10 competitors or even all of your competitors' performance in a single page, you might have to reconsider this. If you need to blend data sources, you are limited to up to 5. errors in Data Studio are also very common. So make good friends with the idea of troubleshooting. My best advice here is to use version control to avoid some messy situations during client calls. While difficult, also try to get your devs to include a date for the implementations in the progress tracking sheet. That way you can proactively monitor the changes that are being done. Do this by blending your progress tracking sheet with the ChromeUX report data. This will allow you to see whether your changes have made an observable impact on the site's reported page experience. Finally, use dashboards interactively with your stakeholders. Give them access. Get their hands dirty. Pique their interest in this topic. Create a sense of urgency. Page experience is a shared cause, and it should be considered one. Start a real conversation, as this might be the key to getting your recommendations implemented. And finally, thank you for hearing my talk. If you have any questions, tips, or observations about how Core Web Vitals have impacted your site, or anything related to the topic whatsoever, feel free to start a conversation with me over at Twitter. Thank you.